one day Dolores came in and said, okay, I have an idea for a new song. And she said, have you any distortion pedals? You know, it needs to be angry, it needs to be loud. And because the place was so small, everyone was always saying, oh, Jesus, turn it down, you know, turn the amps down. I can't hear myself. Try not to hit the drums so hard. But on this day, she was there, okay, hit the drums, turn the amps up. We need power and anger. She played it, we started jamming along, and then got the feel for it. And after, it was almost instantaneous, we kind of had that vibe of what it should be. And then we went off on tour shortly after that, the tour for the first album. And you know, we started working on that and sound check on Zombie, and then yeah, put it into the set list. And it kind of had stayed in the set list since then, because that first night we played it, nobody knew the song. And by the second chorus, they were all chanting along. It was just surreal. We were kind of going, okay, this song works.
It's a grunge song. You know, it was like, well, the band had been touring. They suddenly kind of got into loving Smashing Pumpkins and Soundgarden and all this kind of grunge thing, which was really big at the time in America. And so when the guy said, oh, we want to do this rock, kind of this really kind of rocky, grungy song, I thought, it's great, let's have a bit of fun, you know, let's just go for it. There was no pressure about making it a single whatsoever. This was like, for me, an outlier on the album. It was just like, hey, let's have some fun. It's a bit like how I did song two with Blur later on the Blur record. There was no pressure about, this has to be a single. None of that at all. No input from the label or management about it whatsoever. It was like the band would let off a bit of steam, you know. Noel's bought some new guitar pedals and a guitar with a heavier pickup on it, and he wants to rock out a bit. Okay, let's do it, you know. And we just had fun. We just lashed into it, you know, stacked up the guitars, and so we had that kind of stereo-wide, you know, heavy, grungy chorus and everything, and just had fun with it. And I think that's the reason why it works so well, is because we weren't kind of getting paranoid about, we've got to make it a hit single. We just did what we wanted to do with it. And then sure enough, it's become the biggest hit record they've ever made.
It was called In Your Head initially. I remember the set list written down In Your Head, and it stayed as that until we recorded it. And Dolores decided to change the name to Zombie because she just preferred that name. And yeah, the decision to release it as a single was our decision. And it was kind of met with a bit of trepidation from the record company, kind of saying, oh, it's a bit controversial. I don't know. It's a bit heavy. It's, you know, maybe not a good idea. Our argument was, look, we've been playing it for over 6 months live, and you know, the reaction is incredible from the audience every night. I think it's a great idea to release it as a single, you know. And they got behind us then once, you know, we made our argument, and fair enough.
The thing is, there is a formula, there is a recipe there, which has been done by the Smashing Pumpkins and Nirvana and, you know, and the Pixies. You know, it's the quiet verse, heavy chorus thing. It's not rocket science, but it works, you know.
Yeah, it's very dynamic. The whole song is very dynamic. And I think that's a part of the Cranberries sound, is that kind of loud, quiet thing and leaving space for the vocals and for whatever there might be, a guitar line or a keyboard line, you know, that comes in every now and again, and it's kind of backing off and leaving space for that. And I think that's an important part of it.
With their taste and their bombs and their guns in your head, in your head, they are cool, yeah. In your head.
were embracing the grunge thing because we all love Nirvana, we all love Pearl Jam, and you know, listen to them a lot when we were touring. You know, you'd have, there's nothing else to do on a long drive, and you listen to music or, you know, watch a movie, but we'd listen to music a lot in vans and on tour buses and stuff. So those bands were definitely an influence on us. And yeah, we weren't concerned about the change in sound because it still sounds like the Cranberries. It's just louder because I think we have been on tour a lot and we're used to that more powerful sound, I think. You know, because when playing live, everything is a bit louder because the adrenaline is up, you're hitting harder and you're playing harder on your guitar or whatever, and you know, there's speakers, so it's harder to hear yourself. So you kind of, yeah, it's a different mentality than being in the studio because you have headphones on, you can hear everything crystal clear. It's like a CD, but live, you're struggling to hear things some nights. And I think it gives an edge to a performance. So I think that's what we were looking for, was that kind of more, yeah, lively, powerful sound.
As I said, because we weren't precious about it. We weren't worried about it being a single. You know, it was just like, this is the band letting down their hair a bit, rocking out a bit. And it means they can put it in their set. Because I think they felt like after they were touring, when they first started, they had so many slow songs. They wanted to put a few more up-tempo songs into the set. You know, and that's why Ridiculous Thoughts was also there, I think, as well. And, you know, they needed some stuff that was a bit more up-tempo. So, you know, that's what Zombie did. And it did more than that. As I said, it's become a monster, really. I mean, it's the biggest selling track they've ever released.
Zombie was such a powerful live song. Once it went into the set, it was always there. And sometimes it might go on a bit longer or, you know, depending on the night and depending on what Dolores was feeling and she would say. But I always, that song more than anyone, I always kind of gave that extra bit of power to, because yeah, it's a very emotional song, and the subject matter about the murder of two innocent boys is still something that kind of gives me a lump in my throat, you know, when I think about it, especially having kids yourself. It makes it even more more emotional to listen to it. Sometimes Zombie is misunderstood, but again, you know, people take different things from different songs, and you know, once the song is out in the open, it's fair game for anyone to decide what they like or don't like about the song. Yeah, it was written 30 years ago, and the information is there if you want to go and look about what this song was originally about. But as time progressed, it became more a song for peace, you know, and a song about peace, and hopefully that day will come, but it doesn't seem like it at the moment with all that's going on around the world. So yeah, I think as time progressed, Dolores would kind of say that this song is a song of peace, you know, when we were playing it live, you know, it's an anthem of peace rather than violence.
Yeah, I mean, it's blindingly simple, and I'm sure some guitarists would be kind of like shaking their head at it going, you know, well, there's no technique there whatsoever. But, you know, for me, it's a bit like the Buzzcocks, you know, that one finger guitar solo, you know, and on the early punk singles, you know, it's kind of, I like that. It's like, it's Dolores playing the guitar. It's her part. That's what she wants to play on it. Let her do it, you know. there was no kind of doubt for me that we had to change it and kind of get her to play it in a more technical way. It is how she played guitar, you know. And I do love the bit at the end where it kind of drops down, you know. And what I love about that bit at the end, actually, is that when it drops down to the bass line, you can feel the tempo change. It slows down initially and then it starts picking up again. And I love that because, I mean, nowadays a lot of people have everything gridded out. It's got to be the same tempo all the way through. Whereas we just used a click, I think, just for the beginning and the first chorus. And once we got past there, we just took the click out so the band could, you know, go with the music. And I love that. And you can really hear it, that bit, especially towards the end. It really does change in tempo. But it felt right, so we went with it, you know.